time when most people were expecting Sierra Leone to have been announced Ebola-free, a year after registering the first case in Kalaung district. The spike in new cases has raised some concerns, especially when it's been reported that some people in the north are escaping from quarantine homes, whilst others are still burying their dead relatives secretly, and others still going to herbalists for treatment. Magazine Wharf in Freetown is one of the new communities in the western area to have reported a new confirmed Ebola case. Our reporter Amadu Lamrana visited the slum community and filed this report.
After registering two deaths with an index case from Kafo Bulom in the Potloko district, over 150 people are under quarantine at Magazine, a slum community that depicts abject poverty and negligence with poor sanitation to an extent that residents could not manage excretion while pigs search for food in the field. According to Ibrahim Mansari, head of the Community Ebola Task Force, since the confirmation of the index case, they forced those who had come into contact with the individual into self-quarantine until the authorities arrived. He said before now, they have been very vigilant in protecting their community from being infected for the third time, but unfortunately, they were unable, especially when people are refusing to report suspected cases. While some of those who are in quarantine complain of being supplied expired food, others registered their concerns over the poor sanitation and security along the coastal area, with people traveling from Lunga to the community unchecked. Chief Executive Officer of the National Ebola Response Center, NAC, retired Major Alfred Palu Conte, who was also visiting the community coincidentally, said they are very much concerned that the virus is returning to slum communities where sanitation is very poor and the possibility of transmission is high.
It is a concern because of the densely populated area. But, you know, we've dealt with it before and we'll do our best and make sure we snuff the disease out of these areas, particularly these slum communities, you know, because it's not good.
He said Potloko and Cambia districts are still posing as a threat and an easy access to transmission to slum communities in the western area, which is why NAC is moving into those communities with more enforcement on social mobilization and security and cutting down the chain of transmission. Palo Conte, whilst calling on traditional and religious leaders to continue with their engagement and sensitization in their communities, having in mind that Ebola is still in the country, he appealed to the public to adhere to the laid down procedures of reporting the sick and call the 117 emergency hotline if anyone dies. For Star TV, Amadou